The mother of a Pacific student is outraged after she says that her daughter was put into a chokehold that made her pass out during recess.
In a Fox 2 exclusive, Chris Renier reports the mother is criticizing the school's response, but district leaders say they acted appropriately.
It makes me feel really upset.
10-year-old Riley Desmond gets emotional talking about it. So does her mom, Amanda.
She was terrified.
The incident happened back on September 30th in this track area at Pacific Intermediate School. Riley says she was at recess when one of her friends got behind her and put her in what she calls a chokehold or a headlock. She tells us she passed out and woke up with a chin injury and two of her friends standing over her, including the one who put her in the hold.
It was just hard to think that she would do that to me.
She said, what's wrong with me? Why would anyone not help me? And that broke my heart, obviously.
Amanda says no teacher helped her daughter right away, and that when Riley went to the nurse's office and told her what happened, the nurse only cleaned her chin and gave her an ice pack. Amanda says she filed a report with Pacific Police and then took her daughter to the ER. She told us Riley was diagnosed with a neck injury and is now wearing a brace.
She did not get the proper help at all. She should have had some sort of vitals done. As soon as she said she passed out or lost, the nurse could have taken her blood pressure and realized that she probably just woke up from that.
John Mulford, the Pacific superintendent, says this is a case of horseplay gone too far. He tells me the other girl admits putting Riley into a chokehold and that Riley fell. But based on the school's investigation, he says it does not appear that Riley was choked to the point of passing out.
I think it's probably more likely if she passed out, it was from hitting her chin or her face or head on the ground.
Mulford tells me he's still investigating when teachers learned about the incident and how they responded. He says Riley did not tell the nurse she was choked or had passed out. That, Mulford says, came out later in the day.
I have no doubt that our teachers did respond the way we would want them to, and the way I would want them to respond to my child.
Mulford says the other student was disciplined. Riley hasn't been back to school since the incident.
I pray every day that she's going to get better.
Chris Fournier, Fox 2 News.
Pacific Police do confirm that an assault report was filed, and they've turned that case over to juvenile authorities. Investigators say no charges have been filed at this point, though.